there could be another explanation for Daphne's problems. She's starting a period. It could be premenstrual syndrome.
Yes, I wondered about that myself, but there's no mention of it in her medical records from Barnhurst.
I noticed. I also noticed that it was a Dr. Cuthbert who made out those records. Okay. The nursing profession's been having a running battle with him ever since PMS was discovered. He just won't accept it exists. He calls it an excuse for troublemakers.
That's ridiculous.
Well, not to an arch-conservative like him, it isn't. He's still back in the 19th century.
I think it's time we started our own checking. Thanks for your help. I'll get onto it straight away.
Hello? Blackmore Detention Centre?
Oh, yes. Hello. Is Cynthia Leach there, please?
Speaking.
Well, I should have recognised that voice. It's Joan Ferguson.
Joan? How are you keeping?
Well, I've been better. Listen, I need a favour. Do you have much access to Ruth Ballinger?
Oh, yes. I don't go near her any more than I can help there. I like the smell.
I know what you mean. Listen, Cynthia, this is really important. It's life and death, if you know what I mean. Do you think you can help me?
Anything for a friend. What do you want me to do?
Now, what's this all about?
Mrs. Goddard was just here. George the gardener found ladder marks underneath Nana's window the night before she was killed.
The night before?
Yes. Someone attacked her that night. She woke up screaming that someone was trying to kill her, but when I went in, there was no one there. Whoever killed her came back again the next night.
It is possible, I suppose.
It's what really happened. And once Mrs. Goddard gets George to tell the police, well, they can go after the real murderer.
Now, you can't say I'm not a romantic at heart. Here we are, an old married couple, and I'm still bringing home wine and roses. Oh, the lass is lost for words. Hey, you look like you've seen a ghost. There's been no word from our solicitor friend, has there?
I think I can help you out there, Dean.
This is just between us.
Yes, so it is. We are like an audience. You're going to watch, aren't you, love? Watch your pommy boyfriend get what he deserves.
Please.
Come on, this isn't getting you anywhere.
Yeah, you're right, Crookshank. I'm wasting time.
No!
Don't worry. I've got something better in mind. I'm going to make sure you suffer, boyo.
Then when I finish having fun with him,
you can come and watch me get in a cry. You'd like that. Yeah. Ah! Stinking screws!
What happened?
A bomb. I let Gary from next door. I let him borrow the car to pick up Tina before I went back to work. And when he turned the key, it
off. Where is she?
You've got eyes.
Miss Malone, I know this must be a shock.
Shock? It could have been her, not her neighbour. God, how many more people have got to get hurt before you lot do something about Ballinger and his mob?
Till the cause of the fire has been properly investigated, we won't be laying charges against anyone. If you'll excuse me, I need a statement.
And we need protection. Now you start providing it, or I will kick up such a stink you're going to be sorry you ever met me.
Oh, good, they've fixed the telly.
No, it's a new one, Ed. The latest thing, black and white.
Oh, that's my favourite. But they're still showing the same shows, aren't they?
Anybody want to go? You want to go in, Banjo?
Don't call me that. No, I'm going to play with someone who lets a mate take a murder rap for him.
I'll stuff ya.
Rotten bitch.
Should be court-martialed, that one.
Eh?
You need people you can trust in the battle zone, do you?
Poor Daffy, then. Dodging bullets with only the freak as an offsider.
Yeah, it's a wonder she didn't use you for a shield. I'm just happy the Barbie was there.
Hey, they didn't shoot my statue, did they?
No.
Oh, eighth wonder of the world, dear. They wouldn't dare.
Oh, you don't appreciate the work of art, you stupid old cow.
You watch who you're calling names around here, you silly little
wife.
God, haven't we had enough trouble around here without you two going off hammer and tongs at each other?
Hey, where are you going, Chuck?
Oh, sorry, you don't mind it. I just want to go and have a lie down.
Sure, go on, love. Now see what you've done.
Excuse me, but I refuse to sit here any longer and take any more insulting innuendos from a half-witted dried-up old prue with one foot in the grave.
Take that back. Willoughby, a beat you.
You two play. I've lost my enthusiasm.
No, I think I'll go and see if Chucky's okay.
I'll leave it for a bit, love. She looked like she needed a good cry.
Yeah, I know how she feels. You know, I was so shook up after the shooting that I couldn't stop crying.
Bet Burgess will love that.
No, she didn't seem to notice. Hey, she's scared, mate.
The freak?
Yeah.
That time she was on the receiving end.
Looks like Lady Hartley wants you.
Oh, g'day, Jen. Hey, what's that?
Terrific news. But it's just between you and me, okay?
Yeah, okay. I'm real good at keeping secrets.
I think I've found a way of proving my innocence.
That's great! Hey, why can't I tell the others?
When the courts clear me, then we'll tell them.
That's real good. Hey, there's going to be a few surprise faces around here, isn't it?
G'day. Mind if I come in? Since when did you start asking? Look, I don't blame you for being sore, but I'd like you to have this.
What for?
Oh, I don't know. It's to show you I'm not a total dog, I suppose.
Kate, this hope's not going to make up for 10 more bloody years in this hole.
Yeah. I don't reckon I could ever make that up to you. I'm real sorry. Honest. I don't deserve a mate like you, that's for sure.
Yeah, well, I thought you
were gonna... I mean, look, you just can't forget all we've been through together. All the rackets we've run and the flack we've had to take from nerds in here who reckon they own the joint. But at least we ain't got Desmond on our backs no more.
Yeah. Rotten way to go, though.
Yeah. Good for our pockets, though.
How do you mean?
If we were both on the council, we could run any racket we wanted.
One hitch. You ain't on the council.
Yeah, but May's only filling in.
Yeah, but the others would vote no rackets anyhow.
If we were both on the council, we could fix that. You and me. Collecting every bit of spare cash in the joint. Look, we'd have it rolling in.
All right. But it'd have to be 50-50, okay?
Fair enough. Fair enough.
You know I'd do anything to help a mate, but...
Look, I wouldn't have involved you if I didn't have to.
One of Fellow's things could be watching us right now. I've got problems of my own. I can't afford to make any slips.
Come on, Cynthia.
Well, what about the cops? Can't they do anything?
For God's sake, we're talking about Arnie Ballinger.
There's a way I can get him off my back.
What's this?
It's a photocopy of the file on Ruth Ballinger's child porn racket. You show that to the women at Blackmore, and she is as good as dead.
Then
I tell Fellows to leave off, or Arnie Ballinger is a widower.
I think you're doing him a favour. She's been a bit of a problem to him lately.
Then I'll just have to count on the fact that he wants her alive. It's the only chance I've got.
What do you want me to do?
Well, for the moment, just stir the women into giving her a bit of a bashing. I'll take it from there.
I don't know, Joan.
Oh, come on, Cynthia. Look, I'll make it worth your while. Please.
Don't know where McCrae's living, do you?
No.
Pity. Could have taken you both to his place, made a real party of it. You know, all that time I thought about paying you bastards back. I never dreamt it'd be so easy.
My
shit, boyo! I want to watch it, Crookshank. We'll end up watching her get it first. And that'll make me real mad, because her and me are going to have some fun. Aren't we, sweetheart?
No!
Okay, get rid of her.
You're in the bag.
You ready? We better get a move on, otherwise we'll be late.
Joyce, I'm not going back to work.
Oh, why?
I don't feel very well.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is there anything I can get you, dear?
No, no.
Oh, well, I'll let them know at work then, shall I?
Yes, would you tell Anne about the C12 forms? I'll work on them here.
Yes, all right. Well, I hope you're feeling better soon, dear.
Yes, so do I.
All right.
Not a foot wrong, sweetheart. Pity, because I'm itching to pull this trigger. Boom! And make the story good, bitch. Thought you'd get me, did you? Not letting me know you're supposed to be at work.
I forgot, honestly.
Hello, Wentworth Detention Centre.
Hello, Dennis here.
Oh, Dennis, it's Terry.
Hello, Terry.
Hi.
I just thought I'd let you know Meg won't be in tonight. She's come down with something.
Oh, all right.
It's probably just a 24-hour book.
Oh, okay then, Dennis. Well, thanks for letting us know. Bye.
There. That wasn't too hard, was it? Now let's crack open another bottle before we get down to business. Huh? Can't enjoy me liquor standing over a couple of bodies. Now, can I?
Fellows, look, you're wasting your time and mine. There's nothing I can do to stop Bellinger's orders, so do us both a favour and make this the last communication, okay?
Wait. Now, you listen, fellows. You can't afford not to.
All right, spit it out.
I have lined Ruth Bellinger up for trouble. Now, if you don't call off your trigger-happy friends, you're going to be responsible for her death, too.
Oh, crap.
And I'll make sure that Arnie Ballinger knows it.
It won't work, Ferguson.
Hey, what's this? Not feeling sick, are you?
No, just feel like lying down, that's all.
Yeah. Well, I can't blame you not hanging around the rec room. You know, I was sitting there just mucking around it. All of a sudden, I got this really weird feeling. Remembering Myra and everything. Oh, I don't know. It's all pretty freaky, really. Hey, come on. I'm not into talking to backs, you know.
I'm sorry.
Got a really bad downer, huh? Oh, no one can blame you. All that shooting and stuff would get anybody down. Don't worry. You'll get over it.
No, I won't. Not in here. I can't handle it anymore, Lex.
Oh, bull. Of course you can. Look, one thing Mum drummed into me all the time when I was a kid, no matter what happens, good or bad, you just say, oh, well, that was a bit rough, or that was nice, or whatever, then you get on with the next thing. You get a hell of a lot more out of life that way than thinking about what happened yesterday.
I wish I could meet you, Mum.
Yeah, we had our Barneys. But she taught me a lot of good stuff.
Mrs. M let me ring my Mum today.
Yeah, how is she?
Oh, she was pretending it didn't worry her. But you could tell, you know.
Yeah. Geez, I don't know how I'd go if I got cancer. Oh, come in, why don't you?
Oh, it's okay. Hey, I just wanted to see who you think would be the best bet to take Desmond's place on the council.
Can't you even let a seat get cold?
Well, I've got to think about it, haven't we?
You should go for that, Lex. You'd be really good.
Yeah, might be all right.
I was thinking Lou would be pretty good.
What?
Oh, no, serious. Better having long-termers. She handled herself pretty well when those blokes were sharing the bullets around.
Forget it. That bitch only cares about herself.
Yeah. Have it your way. But it'd be less painful to vote for her. If you get me drift.
About time. Nothing like it, eh? Booze up, some good grub. Company ain't bad either.
I'll rip your bollocks out, you can't!
Oh, you get out! Just get out!
Go on, I'll hit you!
Hey, nice. A few carrots there. Enough to turn a bloke vegetarian. Come on! Get it off! And we'll go get the rest of the jewels. Might even leave you enough for my boyfriend's funeral. If you're a good girl.
Joan! I've been so worried. What are you doing in here anyway?
Oh, I phoned to speak to you and they asked me to stand in for Morris.
Well, at least you're safe in here. I've been expecting that those animals would try to get to you again.
Yeah. What about you? You all right now?
When I don't think about it. I've rung the hospital and all they say is Gary is as well as can be expected.
At least he's still alive.
I'm so scared.
for both of us. We just can't go home tonight.
Yeah, well, we're not. Look, I've been thinking about it, Terry, and I want you to go to your parents' place. They won't trace you there.
And what about you?
Well, the police have finally decided that I'm worth protecting. They've realised they need me as a witness to Ballinger's escape attempt. Oh, come on. Hey, everything is going to be all right. They're not going to hurt us anymore. I'll see to that.
Bloody junk! Where's the rest of his stuff?
Got any more?
That's right.
Keep out of this, you! You lying bitch! Pick it up for him. Don't forget I'm listening. Or Megs, you'll end up losing a memory.
Hello?
Dennis, it's Joyce. Oh, I've been worrying myself sick about Meg.
I see.
How is she?
No, Inspector, I've not seen hide nor hair of him.
Pardon?
Knowing Frank Burke, though, he could be just doing just the opposite.
Okay, cut the jokes and hang up.
Oh, Dennis, I think we've got a crossed line.
Not at all, Inspector.
No, I'll take over. You go and have your break.
I just rang Dennis. We must have had a crossed line. He was talking to some inspector about Frank Burke.
What?
Ah, Billy, any better?
Yeah, I'll be all right.
You're not missing anything. Nothing much on television. You know, if I'd been still at that retirement village, I wouldn't be standing around here waiting for something to happen. Sadie and I would be up and about.
You miss her, don't you?
Yeah, oh yeah, she was very nice. But when I first went there, there was this really nice gentleman. I've forgotten his name now, but gee, he was a nice bloke. He'd been to Africa. Have you been overseas?
No.
No, me neither. But he went to sea when he was 14. A lot of boys did that in those days. I used to go to see the world. You don't hear of boys doing that anymore, do you?
Well, maybe not at 14.
No. Well, not on the outside. I met these two, what do you call them now? Bugs. Bugs?
Bugs?
No. No, punks, that's right. Where do I get bugs? Anyway, they couldn't be much more than 16, but they were always in trouble, just wasting their lives, you know. Idle hands, you see.
Well, there's a lot of pressures on kids.
Yeah, I suppose they get confused. Someone should help them, you know. Especially the girls. There are lots of things they could do, but they seem to mess it up somehow.
Like me.
Oh, no, you're too clever. You won't make the same mistake twice. You know, if I'd been a boy, I would have gone to Africa. I'd like to ride on an elephant all round Kenya. I can still remember the names of the places I'd like to go to. Mombasa, Zanzibar, Narrabri. Good names, aren't they?
Narrabri's in New South Wales.
Is it? Oh, you're so clever. You're wasting your time in here. What are you going to do when you get out?
Oh, I don't know. Look after me mum, I suppose. If she ever gets better.
Oh, of course she will. Come to think of it, you know, we all need looking after sometimes, don't we? Old soldiers and sailors and punks. I reckon we should all get a fair crack of the whip, don't you?
Yeah, I suppose we should.
Give me a minute and then send them in. Well, come in.
How are you, Lionel?
Oh, can't complain. Have a seat. And to what do I owe this little pleasure?
I thought you might be able to help us out with a bit of a problem we've got.
Well, fire away. You know I'm always happy to help where I can.
Yeah, I've heard.
What about a drink? I'll get Fran to send in a tray.
Maybe later. Does the name Joan Ferguson mean anything to you?
Ferguson? No.
But she's had a few unfortunate accidents in the past couple of days. House fire, sniper attack, car bomb.
Sounds like somebody doesn't like her, eh? Put it down, mate. Unless you blokes have got a search warrant.
Well, I didn't think we'd need one. I mean, a nice, respectable businessman like yourself has nothing to hide, right?
Right. But let's just stick to the reason you're here, eh? I'm a busy man.
Of course. You know, if that offer for drink still stands, wouldn't mind a coffee. How about you, Ron?
Goddamn well.
Right. Friend, send in two coffees and my usual. Tala. Right, boys. Let's see what I can do to help.
Oh, where the hell did I put it? Have you seen my red wool?
No, I haven't. And I hope you're not insinuating anything by that. Out.
Can I have a word with you?
I said get out of here, Miss Parslow.
Pull up a bed, love, and let's hear it.
Stupid, ignorant, silly little old woman. Oh, what's the problem? Oh, what isn't? She's one big one herself.
I was wondering whether it wouldn't be a good idea if I left here and went to live on the outside.
What's brought this on? Senility. It's got to be.
I'll have you know I've given it very serious thought. You see, the problem is I've got all this lovely money in the bank and I could do such wonderful things with it.
Oh, Eddie, you're a prize, love, you really
I don't think good works are very funny.
I'm sorry, love, it's a terrific idea, but you've got to
you
be...
You see, the question is, do I open a home for war veterans or do I do something for the kids? I mean, after all, they've got their whole lives ahead of them.
Eddie, love, I don't want to be a wet blanket, but I think you've got a few problems ahead of you before you get to the good deeds.
What problems? I might have enough for both.
Eddie, you held up a bank to get back in here. And the way you carried on at your committal, well, you'll have a hell of a job to convince them to let you out again.
Oh, no, dear. Meg will take care of all that for me.
Right, you two around the back. You two stay here. Frank and I are going inside.
There you are, Megsy. Don't say I ain't fair. Got to play fair, haven't we, Cruikshank? Now get over there.
Don't be a fool. You'd be up for life.
Worth it, boy. Oh, bloody worth it. Now move!
Any sugar or ran out?
Oh, sure.
What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. Just thinking.
What about?
Oh, nothing.
Oh, my mum used to say you couldn't think about nothing. She used to say her brain was always thinking about something. I reckon my brain's thinking about nothing, I think.
Ain't that enough?
Oh, four.
Four?
Yeah. Is that all right?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. What were you thinking about?
Oh, I was just thinking about Myra and the kids. How much she loved them.
Yeah. Her daughter was a drug addict, wasn't she?
Yeah. I think Myra always blamed herself for that. But she's clean now.
Yeah. Must be real hard to be a parent sometimes, I reckon. Anyway, thanks. I'll see ya.
Yeah, I reckon.
Yeah, thank you, Sergeant. I'll let the governor know.
Was that about Meg and Dennis?
Yes.
What happened?
Well, they caught Burke. Crookshank's been taken to hospital. Bullet wounds.
God, it's my fault. If only I'd realised when I went to get Meg.
If you had, Mrs. Barry, you'd probably be dead by now. Phone's ringing.
Mrs. Morris?
Yes?
Would you like a cup
Dennis,
of tea?
Where is he? Is he all
right? Yes, dear, he's doing fine.
Now,
keep a hold on yourself. He'll be all right. He's in surgery at the moment, but everything's going to be all right.
Thanks.
I'll have someone bring you a nice strong cup of tea.
No, it's all right.
Fine.
Oh, sister!
What?
Look, to such a trap, Burke.
Give me some
help.
Give me some help.
Give me some help. Give me some help. Come on, lady, calm down.
Stupid bitch!
Oh, who is it this time?
Holly Williams.
Who?
You surely remember Holly.
I can't say I do.
The cafe in Carlton. He was such a good customer. Horace Albert Williams, suddenly at home. God saw that you were weary. He did what he thought best. He closed your eyes and took you to a place of rest.
Oh, don't start, Willie.
Oh, how could you, May? He was a dear, dear friend of mine. Why, I remember when he almost lost the business. What do you care?
Oh, what is it this time?
Oh, nothing. Just reading the obituaries again.
As if there isn't already enough depressing stuff around here.
How's Julie?
No, she's okay. Mum's getting her down too. Tell you what, though, I think we ought to keep an eye on Kelly.
Uh-huh.
Oh, something's cooking, that's for sure. Lush came around looking for her to get on the council.
That's what she's up to.
Here's a news update. Yes. A dramatic incident tonight in which...
Hey, shut up, you lot, look at this!
...criminal Francis Burke after a shootout in which off-duty prison officer Dennis Crookshank was seriously wounded.
What? A
police spokesman said Burke had held two prison officers at gunpoint for over 3 hours before shooting Crookshank, who's now undergoing emergency surgery at Home
General Hospital with
serious injuries to both legs.
Oh.
And now, the weather.
Come on, ladies. Come on, time to go.
It
was on TV.
Yeah, all the boring details.
Is he going to be all right? Oh, yes. Come on, get back to yourselves, quickly.
Well, Mrs. B, you will keep us posted on
Yes, of course I will. Now, come on, move along, quickly.
Sim's so nice, it's just awful.
Oh, come on, Patterson.
Just fix him a shoe. Look, Mrs. B, there's something I've got to talk to you about.
Yes, but you better make it quick. Hurry up.
Well, you remember that money you lost?
Yes.
Well, you were right. I pinched it. Look, Morris said you'd get it back in your will, so don't worry, okay? Yeah, all right.
Come on, Mr. Crookshank. That's it. Time to wake up. Come on.
Nurse said it would be all right for me to come in now.
Yes, come in.
Meg?
How are you feeling?
It's all right,
Meg. Meg's here.
Don't stay too long.
It's all right. Oh, darling, it's me.
We'd better hurry up.
Just rest, darling.
Burke, where is he?
He's been caught. It's all over.
Mrs. B mentioned anything about Mara's funeral tomorrow?
No. Did she happen to say anything about Eddie or me going?
No, not a word.
I didn't think Mrs. Reynolds would let us down like that.
Oh, she can't. I've already done the flowers and Jen's writing out a special card.
Yeah. It's all right, love. We're all going to miss her.
It's Horry's funeral tomorrow, too.
Huh? Has anyone heard how Mr. C is? Yes,
come on,
Lex. Shut up. I'm just asking a question.
Yeah, well, we asked Lex, but Miss Ferguson just told us to go jump.
You're a rotten bitch.
I think she's got her own problems at the moment.
Who gives a stuff? Hey, where's the grub anyway?
Oh, hey, presto. What's with the double rations?
That's why we're a bit late. I talked Mervyn to cook an extra to cheer us up a bit.
Oh, I'm not hungry.
Hey, how come it smells fishy, Kelly?
Mine doesn't, no.
Because Flynn's just suspicious. Right, Flynn? But believe it or not, I thought I could do something to help buck our spirits up a bit.
Cripes.
She didn't even choke.
G'day, Burke.
have to stop eating this way.
Stop it, Pritchard.
Be nice now, Frankie.
You're bloody lucky I don't complain.
Hey, Aaron, what is it this time? I don't think they'll swallow the police brutality bit. But after the black eye you gave Pete last night.
An accident. Anyway, deserved it.
Crookshank earlier,
don't push me, cover! The next time I get out, I'll have a new name on my list! Bastard! You staggered cop!
He's all yours, mate.
Gee, thanks.
7.
4-8-0.
I'll
make you pay!
2, be good now, Frankie.
Staggered cop!
Visitor for you, Mr. Crookshank? I'll put these in water for you.
Thanks.
That's what I like.
A woman who brings a man flowers can't be all bad.
Yeah, you're obviously feeling a bit better this morning.
I am. I'm being spoilt rotten. If you weren't worried about it.
You can stop this minute. I'm perfectly all right. How do they feel?
A bit funny. They keep pumping injections into them. It's like they've gone off in a world of their own.
Son. Oh, thank God you're all right.
Hey, don't worry. I'll be back chasing you around the bedpost before you know it.
Good. Ferguson.
Oh, morning, Governor.
You look as though you need more than a coffee break. Why didn't you take Joyce's offer to get a replacement for the next shift?
I'll manage.
As you wish. I just rang the hospital, by the way. Dennis is recovering well.
That's good. Must have been quite an ordeal for them both.
Dreadful. I suggested Meg take the day off, but she wouldn't hear of it.
Yeah, I can understand that. Preferring to be here than at home where it happened.
That's why you're staying to do another shift, isn't it?
Safer here than outside.
Yes.
I only wish that I had shot Ruth Ballinger when I had the opportunity. Would have saved everybody a hell of a lot of trouble.
Wouldn't have solved anything.
It would for me.
God, it's quiet in here. Makes me feel like singing at the top of my voice or something.
Well, I'm reveling in it. It's a rare thing around this place.
Yeah. I don't know, I'm beginning to feel like I'm in a dream or something.
What do you mean, love?
It's hard to explain. Since Myra's gone, I've lost the last of my mates. Oh, my old mates, that is. I don't know, I feel really weird, like I'm going to walk around the corner and bump into them or something. Especially Myra, she's... Well, she was something else.
How'd it go?
Oh, Mrs. Reynolds says she had to wait for the okay from Fry.
Oh, forget it then. He's an A-grade bastard.
But they have to let one of us go to the funeral, for God's sake.
Look what I've got.
Oh, good. What is it now?
They're not in mint condition. Come on, you willy chocolate-coated. Okay, if I take a break, mate?
Before? You're not getting my biscuits, girl.
You selfish bitch.
Oh, how do you know these were a gift?
Who from?
Lou. She got them from the kitchen.
What's Kelly after?
She's bucking for the council.
She's got hopes.
I think she'd be very good.
Then you come cheap, Willie.
Never a truer word said.
What are you insinuating?
Oh, forget it. Where's Daphne?
Oh, they've taken her off to see the shrimp again.
Poor kid was shaking in her boots. Well, I hope he can fix up a problem, that's all.
Bribery! That's what you're suggesting, isn't it? Do you think I've accepted a bribe?
You see, little
buggy. That's the most insulting... I just don't believe it. A person does a good turn and you all read evil intent into it.
Kelly never did a good deed in her life.
Well, that's ridiculous. Your spite, young lady, is only exceeded by your jealousy.
You ignorant bitch!
Don't you speak to me, mate! I will when
you
she apologises!
Shut up!
God, I don't know. We've just been through bloody hell together. We've even lost mates.
Now, let's just get it straight what's important around here, all right?
All right. Let's try another game. This time, I'm going to show you some cards with different colours on them. Now, each time I show you a card, I want you to look at it very carefully and tell me exactly what comes into your mind. Just the first thing that comes into your head, okay? All right. Now, here's the first card. Well, just the first thing that comes into your head.
Blue.
That's right, blue. Now, what does blue make you think of?
Nothing.
All right, we'll try a different card.
Purple?
And what does purple make you think of?
Veronica.
Veronica?
Yes, she's my African violet.
Well, let's talk about Veronica.
Well, see, I got myself a bit upset and I smashed her on the floor.
Why'd you do that?
Well, I don't know. It was the same day I went up on the roof.
How long were you feeling depressed before you did that?
I don't know, a few days. Hey, why do you keep asking when everything happened?
Well, if we know why you get depressed, we might be able to help you.
Hey, I'm not mental or anything. Just because I talk to me plants says it's good for him on the telly doesn't mean I'm mental.
I don't think you are. No, I talk to my plants too.
Do you?
Yeah. I don't tell anyone either. have you always liked plants?
Yeah. I got a job in the florist shop once. I wasn't for long, but...
Why? What happened?
Well, I was doing real good for a couple of weeks. I was really loving it. And, one day this customer came in and started complaining about stuff. I don't remember what. And I got a bit upset, that's all.
According to your record, you were a bit more than just upset.
Yeah, well... Well, see, he didn't know the difference between a cymbidium and a hyacinth, and he got me real mad, so I chucked him on stereo at him and I just ended up smashing the whole place
all right,
up.
Look, I'm not screwy.
I'm all right now. I'm not going up on the roof anymore, and I wasn't even going to jump anyway. I'm not mental.
I don't think you are.
Well, why do I have to keep seeing your psychiatrist? Then everyone thinks I'm bananas.
I think you may have a problem, but I think it might be more physical than mental. Now, listen, when you smashed up this florist shop, do you remember if it was just before you had your period?
Well, what do you mean by that?
Well, you may have certain hormonal imbalances. At a certain time of the month, the chemicals in
your body... Look, I've already told you, there's nothing wrong with me. I'm not loony, I'm not.
Hey, you lot, bet you can't guess what's for lunch.
Same boring old thing.
Nah, talk moving. It's something real special.
Oh, what? Oh, wait
till you get there, it's a surprise.
Oh. Cripe, she's pathetic.
Who gives her stuff? As long as she keeps a good grub coming, eh?
So long as you know that's all she's good for.
Oh, look at this.
Talk about the weight of a man's stomach.
Yeah. Hey, what is it, love? Psychiatrist give you a bad time?
Auntie May, it was just awful.
What?
Well, he kept asking these questions about private stuff. You just don't talk like that to fellas. It's one of them perverts if you ask me.
Was sister there all the time?
Nah. He got me mixed up too. He kept asking about the dates when I wasn't down and the dates when I was down. I don't know. I thought he's okay when I first saw him. Now I reckon he thinks I'm a real loony.
Oh, come on, how could he, love? You're safer than most of us. Stop putting worries where they don't need to be.
Come on, Daphne, May's right. Sounds to me like they think it's physical.
No, he latched onto some real maniac stuff. He thinks I'm a real nutcase.
Oh, Daphne.
Poor kid. I'm sure she got it screwed up somewhere.
Me too, but convincing her is not going to be easy.
I'm surprised there haven't been more suicide attempts, actually, considering what those women have been through. Well, in Daphne's case, I think it would have happened anyway, siege or no siege. Oh, maybe not the extent of an attempted suicide, but definitely a deep depressive state.
No dates?
Yeah. Let's have a look. Note the date she was in trouble, one way or another. Conclusions? Just as you and Sister Hall suspected. A textbook case of premenstrual stress.
What do we do now?
Well, I'd ask you to keep a close check. And if the next bout of depression coincides with the days just before the period, it's fairly certain that we've hit the nail on the head.
All right. Well, before we go on with this, you do know what it'll mean, don't you? She could have a very good chance of having her charges dropped.
Well, looks like we've got a fight in our hands, doesn't it?
Oh, Joan, I'm sorry you had to fill in for me last night. They should have asked for somebody else.
Why? I was available.
You've done more than your share of double shifts this week.
So what's new? Listen, I'm pleased that Dennis is going to be all right.
Thanks. I'm going to see him this afternoon, I'll tell him. You know, I really thought Frank Burke was going to kill him.
They had to bring the death penalty back for maniacs like Burke. Locking him up doesn't make the public any safer. He'll only get out again.
Joyce told me about the bombed car. Is Terry's neighbour all right?
Oh, yeah, pull through.
It's been dreadful for you not knowing what he's going to do next. Sorry, it sound awful.
That's all right. I'll survive. Listen, those reports are there by the phone.
Oh, thanks. Did you get that message?
What message?
From Cynthia? What was it? She said she thought you'd like to know that her cousin's been taken seriously ill and be spending a few days in hospital.
Oh, thanks.
You and Jen sure sparked up during lunch, Daffy.
Oh, yeah. She's real stoked because her lawyer's coming this arvo.
I know it's boring around here, but getting excited about one of those money grabbers is a bit over the top.
Oh, no, she's... Oh, well, it's a secret. She'll tell you later. Hey, wasn't that good news about Mr. Seagull?
Yeah, he's a nice man, that one. It's not like that one we had at Barnhurst.
Well, let's do something then. Like send a get well card.
Oh, hey, yeah. And I could put a pot plant with it.
Terribly sorry.
Oh, Willie, you gave me such a fright. I thought there's something wrong with the dryer.
Now, that'll teach you, madam. I mean, did you see three helpings?
Oh, yeah, they were small helpings, dear ones.
Bit of a surprise, Merv cooking up such a beaut dish.
Oh, hey, maybe Mrs. Barry's given him some of her recipes. Hey, yeah. Guess what I just heard? Ruth Ballinger's been beaten to a pulp.
What?
Did you hear that? Came over the news while I was in maternity. Blackmore women did it. She's in the hospital.
Well, good for them. Wished I'd been there. She'd be on a slab for what she did to Myra and Tammy.
Goes to prove. You can't be that evil and get away with it.
Is it all arranged? Did Mrs. Goddard see the police?
Jennifer,
and just... George. She was going to see George. He's the gardener I told you about.
Jenny, sit down, please.
What is it? Mrs. Goddard hasn't changed her mind, has she?
Mrs. Goddard is dead. I'm sorry. I tried to contact her after you rang yesterday, but, well, she was killed before she even got to the police station.
What happened?
Hit and run. Apparently the driver didn't even try to avoid her. Witnesses said the fellow looked drunk.
And George? You saw George?
No, your aunt moved into your grandmother's house and the first thing she and her husband did was to fire the staff.
Poor George. He's worked for Nana all his life.
It's unfortunate for our case. No one knows where he's gone. It seems he's just disappeared.
Word, if you don't mind.
He's asleep anyway.
When will he be able to come home?
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
There's nothing wrong, is there? I mean, the sister did say the operation was successful.
Bone and arterial damage, yes. I'm afraid the nerve tissue is another matter.
Yes, but with physio, I mean, Dennis is a fit man.
You must understand. It was a very delicate operation. We did what we could, but I'm afraid the nerve tissue is beyond repair. It could be years before he's able to walk. You must also face the fact he may never walk again. I am sorry.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face a nightmare. Awaken up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.